Well, good evening, boys and girls. What, why are you here this evening? Anybody know? It's a turkey. Yes.
Jesus' birthday.
That's right, Jesus' birthday. This is Christmas Eve, isn't it? Okay. Now, Jesus was born as a little baby, and what God did was God shaped and molded Jesus to grow up to be a man. And as Jesus, you boys and girls are being shaped and molded by your parents. Do you believe that?
Yeah.
You know that, right? Okay. And as God taught Jesus his teachings and how to be a good man, your parents and through Sunday school are teaching you things as you're being molded and shaped. And as you get shaped, you take on a different form, right? As you go to Sunday school and you go through each older class, right? We get promoted and we go to first grade, second grade, third grade. You learn more and more things. And believe it or not, you're being shaped more and more, aren't you? And that's as Jesus, as he got older, he was shaped more. Now, as we get older, we never stop learning. God, there's always something that God can teach us and that we need to learn to be just like Jesus, right? And we go from little children to teenagers to adults, but we're always learning things. And our strength and our love and knowledge about God just grows and grows. And that's right, sometimes we can go way up here, can't we, with the love that God has for us. And eventually, well, we never really stop, but, you know, we are constantly being molded and shaped, right? And who do we have? That's And as we turn into different young adults, we have Jesus living in our hearts. And with it all started from the star that was in the sky and from Jesus laying in that manger. He's not there right now. I think he's going to be coming a little bit later. But he was there this morning, right? Well, some of you guys weren't here, but he will be back there. And that's how it all started, just in that little manger. And you guys started in this little crib. And look at how big you're getting so far. And this guy started in a crib, and look at how big he got. So you guys are going to grow up too. And that's the message I wanted to give you guys today, is that you get molded and shaped in the church family. All the different members here in the congregation have a responsibility to help and to teach you about God and Jesus and loving and helping others. That makes sense, doesn't it? And God is so proud of us when we do those things. Okay, how about let's say a little prayer. Dear Lord, thank you very much for sending your Son to earth. Lord, you are the overseer. You are the great Father. Lord, without you, we would be nothing. And we are so thankful that the teachings that you give us help us to be better people. Thank you, Lord, for sending your Son, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
All right, I guess if you guys can just get started, we're going to light some candles. You want to hang around here for a little bit? Okay, while we light candles? Can you just clear a path for us?
Jesus Christ is the light of the world. Jesus comes to dispel the darkness, to give us light, and to share as a beacon of God's saving to the world. Christ's light is an eternal flame that sets ablaze hope, peace, joy, and love in the heart of every believer. Let us celebrate Emmanuel, God with us, the light of the world.
We light the Christ candle that Christmas Eve proclaiming the... about the scripture. The scripture is John 8, verse 12. Jesus says, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life.
We light the Christ candle this Christmas Eve proclaiming that Christ, the light of the world, is not beaten, cannot be extinguished, and cannot be overcome. For our Savior, born this day, comes to conquer evil, sin, and death for all time. Please join me in the prayer. Holy God, we are profoundly grateful for the light and the light of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. We acknowledge the darkness in our world and in our own lives, and we ask for mercy and courage to become people of the light. Shine into the darkness of our hearts, exposing what needs to be forgiven, healed, and made whole. Restore us to walk faithfully with you, with all of the heavenly hosts. We praise you for this most precious gift of life and love, Jesus our Redeemer.
Thank you very much, boys and girls, for listening. You can go back with your parents.